this video, we're gonna see how we can slice or create grids in Final Cut Pro 10 using the Slice Pop plugin. I will have a link in the description of this video down below for you to get the Slice Pop plugin. And without any further ado, let's go and find out what we can do with this plugin. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface, and let's find out how we can work with the Slice Pop plugin. As you can see, I have placed the three different angles of the video that you saw in the beginning, and I have placed every angle on top of each other. How we can do that? By simply lift them from the storyline and then add the other layers on top, simply as that. On the bottom, I have the audio, so I don't want the audio of the three different angles to play, so I have only the audio from this angle that I placed it down below. And how we can do that? We click on detach audio and the audio is going to be on the bottom. And of course, I have lowered the volume of the other two angles. Now, for this example, what I did, I went here on the Slice Pop on the effects panel. As you can see with the Slice Pop, so we can do a little bit of an introduction. We have one screen, two screen, three screens, four screens. As you can see, there are plenty of different ideas that you can slice your videos. We have four screens, we have five screens, we have six screens, we have seven screens, and we have eight and nine and 10 screens. So imagine that this is a plugin that you can use to go simple as making, you know, a comparison video that we will do later on. I want to do a comparison video as well, because it's going to be a very useful way to create on your gear reviews videos if you're a YouTuber. For example, the before and after, or the camera of two different phones, or with two different filters that we will do later on. Of course, you can use it to mimic, as you can see here on the nine screens, for example, you can mimic a Zoom call, or you can have different angles of playing an instrument, for example, like here on the piano, for video clips, you can do for social ads. Now, for this one, I went with the Trapezoid App 3. So I'm dragging this and I'm placing it to each of the three different angles. Now, as you can see here, we go into the inspector panel, and we see that we need to select the zone, and we have the build-in and build-out. Let me tell you about this later on, the build-in and build-out. For now, let's disable them, and then we can go to the zone selection. On the zone selection, that means that this video is going to be on the zone 1. I'm going on the video underneath, it's going to be on zone 2, simply as that. And again, I'm disabling the build-in, build-out on the second angle, and on the third again, disabling the animations and selecting zone 3. It took us less than 10 seconds, right? And we have a divided screen with three different angles. Now, as you can see here, by selecting, I can adjust where I want the video to be, up, down, or I can change the size, how much I want it to be zoomed, here in the inspector panel. And of course, this is for all the different angles that I can place here. And then we can have the lines, as you can see here. We can remove the lines if we want, or we can change the color. For example, instead of white, we can do black lines. But remember to do that on each of the different angles. So if I go here and I make everything black, you will see that now all the lines are black. And simply as that, we have the three different angles. Now, how we can do things a little bit more interesting? We can add movements. So if we go here and we go in the inspector panel on the movement section, I can hit on the keyframe on the position and then go at the end of the video, go again here, and change the position of the X axis to here. And as you can see, while we play now, you see that we're having a movement to the left as well. And of course, we can have different effects on the duotone, for example. As you can see, I'm selecting the middle angle here, and I can make it darker, or I can change the duotone to white to make it even brighter. Let's stay on the black, let's make it a little bit darker. It reminds you of the one that you saw in the beginning. And of course, again, we can add a movement as well. Let's make it start from here, add a keyframe, go to the end, and have it here. Same with a keyframe, we can change the size. So we can add a keyframe to the size here, and at the end, while we're moving to the right, we can zoom in as well. So the result is gonna look like this. And we're zooming as well. I'm impressed on how easy it is to splice your videos, splice your angles, have different angles. And let me show you how we can do the build in and build out. So if I enable the build in, let's say, to all of these different angles, you will see that right now it will start from black. And yeah, this is something good. But if I duplicate this layer, which is one of the first angles, and I will give it some space here. Check this out. I'm gonna press B on my keyboard, I'm gonna blade this, I'm gonna delete the effect now, and then I'm gonna drag this, place it here on the bottom. I don't need this anymore. So check this out. From here, I can have the animation, and I can have one angle on the bottom, so I don't have the black. Now, remember that I told you how we can use that for gear reviews as well. Okay, so here we have two different angles. One is with the Moment Cineblum filter, the 20%, one with the 10%. So we're gonna compare the intensity of the filter. I'm gonna use two screens, and I'm gonna have it left and right. Let's do the one with the wave. So I'm placing the left right wave, and this one is gonna be the zone two. I don't want build in and I don't want build out, and I don't want build in and build out to the other as well. So as you can see, one, two clicks, and I have the two different intensities of the two filters that I can use to show on my video the different filters. Mind-blowing, if you ask me. It's very, you know, I'm impressed with Final Cut since I started Final Cut, with plugins that make your workflow faster and basically your life easier. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to like this video, and if you have any questions, I'm waiting them in the comment section down below. Thank you so much to Stupid Raisins for supporting this channel. Thank you so much to you for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next video. Okay, bye.